What's up, Internet? My name is Lamar Engel, and you are watching The Wine Militia. Today because we get to talk about Pinot Noir. So get your hipster boots on, get your emo sweaters on, because we're gonna talk about the most romantic, most eloquent, most appointed grape of all of the world, Pinot Noir. Pinot Noir grows in many different regions throughout the world. There's USA, Germany, New Zealand, Moldova, Switzerland, Australia, France. And some of these places are incredible, but in order to really give a proper nod to Pinot Noir, we have to look at a place in France called Burgundy. This little region is a central eastern part of France.
I don't know why I did that, Mo. Hey, it's over here. Not so much here. It's over here. Whoop, whoop. Like right here. Jack
Cam! And what I can tell you is this is really one of the most romantic places in the world. This is the hub of romanticism for wine in general. When we talk about Burgundy, we're either talking about Chardonnay or Pinot Noir. Today, it's obviously Pinot. What does Pinot Noir mean? Well, because we're in France, let's break it down.
Etymology 101.
The word Pinot Noir can be broken down like this. Pinot, which actually means pine in French, and Noir, which is black in French. So why are we calling it Pine Black? Well, these little Pinot Noir grapes grow in a conical shape and very tight cluster that they almost look like a pine cone. So that's why they look like black pine cones. So where in Burgundy does Pinot Noir grow best? There's a few different regions in Burgundy in itself that we call the Côte d'Or or the Golden Slope. This is one of the most iconic areas for Pinot Noir. Matter of fact, it is the most luscious in terms of flavor and deliciousness.
I love it, yes, absolutely.
And it's also the most sought after. Now you're probably asking,
why Burgundy? Why is Burgundy so special? Why is it such a big deal?
I'm gonna tell you, there are three things that make Burgundy incredibly special. And we sum them up in a word called terroir. Terroir is really an encompassing term that we use to define three things. One, climate. Climate. There are meso, macro, and microclimates within small regions. Topography. Topography, how is the geographical location shaped? Are there hillsides? Are there valleys and ravines? Are there canyons? Is it sandy soil? Is it limestone? Soil and topography are all encompassing. Human touch. Human touch is such a big deal. Whose hands is the Pinot Noir vineyard in?
Because if you're brand new on the block and you're starting to grow Pinot Noir, you're probably gonna need some wisdom from years previous, from years past, from some of our generations before, to really understand that land, to know how much to water, how much to prune.
So we look to them for the wisdom. And in this case, Burgundy has a ton of it.
Pinot Noir has been growing in Burgundy since 96 AD, and the Romans were the first to plant the grapes.
So obviously with a lot of war and a lot of taking over different territories, they need to relax too. So the Romans decided to start drinking Pinot Noir in Burgundy.
I gotta tell you, that's a great idea. More Burgundy, please.
I have with me today the 2014 Scribe Pinot Noir from the Carneros region in Sonoma. Very excited to be able to taste this. The Carneros region in Sonoma is a very unique region. Now, Carneros is the only appellation in Northern California that straddles two counties, Sonoma County and Napa County. And even though it straddles two of those locations, they're very different. Sonoma Pinot Noir is very different than Napa Valley Pinot Noir from the Carneros region. Now, Scribe is a very interesting project, and it all comes down to two guys, Andrew and Adam Mariani.
These two two guys are probably still in their 20s, and they had a brainchild idea to maybe stop doing their day jobs, which weren't quite what they thought they would be.
And decided to do what they love best, farming. Farming is in these guys' blood. This is not a silver spoon situation.
But they're just giving the vineyard to the winery, and they get to pretend that they worked hard.
No. These cats are working hard with their hipster boots and sweaters. I gotta tell you right now, these guys are the real deal. They decided to call their Uncle Andrew Avalar and said,
Hey, Uncle Andrew, listen, we hate our jobs. We want to do something that's gonna matter in life. And that's make people happy. Where can we find a vineyard that, will rock their faces off?
Their Uncle Andrew said,
I know one place. Now this place is gonna be a little bit dodgy because it's got a sordid history. But you guys are up for it.
They said, let's do it.
They went to go check out this little area that was actually a farm. And they found out more than just the sordid history. This dump was a turkey farm.
Now, if you've ever worked on a turkey farm, or any farm for that matter, and seen the aftermath after the livestock have come and gone, this is not smelling roses. This is dump on dump. I've always wanted to say that. Dump on dump.
They found out this property was very much alive and well in the late 1800s by a man named Emil Dressel.
It's story time. Let me tell you a story.
Now, Emil Dressel and his brother Julius, they said,
you know what? The gold rush, it's overrated. Let's make liquid gold.
So they went up north to the Carneros region. They found this property that the Mariani brothers are looking at. They bought the property and they started making amazing wines. Matter of fact, Emil decided to go over to Europe, bring cuttings from his homeland.
A vine that you don't normally see in North America. Sylvaner, or Gruner Sylvaner is what it was called probably back then, and Riesling, and he started grafting them into the vines there to make wine for his roots.
We have Emil Dressel, who is now making wine for all of San Francisco. He's making wine for his nostalgic roots, and he has a brother who's making technological advances to make these roots impervious to pests.
Then comes the nasty thing that we don't like to talk about.
Prohibition.
Now, prohibition just sucks. And here's why. Because nobody really had a conversation with anyone. They just decided to make it illegal for alcohol everywhere. And it really did start in 1919, although 1920 was when the entire United States was blighted with this Prohibition Act.
This vineyard and farm turned into Prohibition's best-kept secret. It became a bootlegger's dream.
Crazy kids.
Cellars tucked away with hidden passages, with wine tucked in them, moonshine, all sorts of different
libations for San Francisco treat.
Apparently they had crazy parties there, and I gotta tell you, it looked like it. Because in 1939, this place then turned into the turkey farm that the two Mariani brothers then discovered. Not quite the vineyard dream that they wanted. They knew it was gonna take a lot of work, and that's what they did.
They did work, son.
Now, experimentation is kind of the name of their game. They like to experiment with different packaging. They like to experiment with different styles of vineyard management. They also like to try different ways of making wine, discovering nuances in their flavors, their wines that no one else is doing.
So that's why I want to taste their wine, because it's different. It's not the same.
And that's why we get passionate here at the Wine Militia.
We love people that do things differently.
Now, Andrew and Adam Mariani decided that they would call upon a gentleman named Christoph Anderson. Now, this guy's been making wine for a couple different wineries, Gargiulo being one of them, and Loma Vista being another one. This guy knows what he's doing. He's been mentored by the great Nils Vange, the Viking winemaker god of Napa Valley.
I have to tell you, these wines are
ridiculous.
So, without further ado, let's dive in. Okay. Oof, wow.
It's a good thing.
Blood orange. Cherry cola. Raspberry jam. Mild tobacco leaf. Rose hips. Dragon fruit.
Love Game of Thrones.
Yes.
Cotton candy. Now, I know what you're saying. Really, Lamar? You're getting cotton candy in here? You don't believe me. Go try it.
I snuck into the circus once, just to get cotton candy and then sneak back out. It's very frightening.
Vanilla bean. Gun muzzle.
It's got a little funk, a little smoke, a little gun muzzle to it. A little... yeah.
It's weird, I know, but it's true.
This wine is very good. You got like a hibiscus thing going on too.
What?
Like stems of hibiscus? I thought I used to chew on hibiscus as a kid. Biscuits? Hibiscus biscuits? Put that in your hipster boots!
This is rocking. This is so good.
Is that the face? Is that the face? Okay, good.
Have I tried Pinot Noirs that were not up to snuff?
Oh boy, have I ever!
Go check them out online. I'm gonna put a little link below. Also, feel free to give them a call if you wanna go visit. They are by appointment only. They would love to see you. They're really cool people.
These guys are probably some of the nicest guys in Sonoma. That's probably a stretch saying that, but they're really super nice.
And their entire staff is incredibly nice as well. And you guys, if you like what you've been seeing and you want to support, go ahead and subscribe.
Hit that little button and we'll do more of this. There's going to be secret videos for the subscribers, so feel free to dive in, if you know what I mean.
Well, you guys, it's been a lot of fun. I hope you guys have had a lot of fun today. And we're going to definitely be doing this again every week.
Every week. So until next time, you guys. Cheers. What? I'm kidding. Totally kidding. I would never do that. Once, maybe. I've done it once. Don't do that. Don't do that. I used to think I was a hipster, and I'm so far from hipster. I don't even know if that's supposed to be a good thing, or... I'm not wearing socks. I didn't shave my legs. Sorry. Actually, don't feel so snobby drinking this now. Thank you, appreciate it. All of the help that you've given, thank you, muchly. Loved it. I loved the Pinot Noir. It's quite sophisticated. It's definitely down my alley. Oh yes, the nuances of clove and something, something, something. Blah 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 blah. I love it. It's just so today. I definitely love this wine. This wine definitely is a cat's pajamas. Or pajamas wearing cats. Up to you. It's your choice.